Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Now and ever and through ages of ages.
Amen. Most holy Trinity, have mercy.
mercy on us, O God. According to thy great goodness, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for all pious and Orthodox Christians.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for our father and Metropolitan Joseph and all our brother Cootie Christ.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
For thou art merciful God, and lovest mankind, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to ages of ages. Substantial life giving undivided Trinity, always now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Father, my soul, fall apart after thee, thy right hand upholds me.
Glory to the Father, and
pride if I had before thee. Let my prayer come before thee, bow down thine ears to my supplication. For filled with evil is my soul, and my life in the gates of our life. I encounter with them, I go down into the pit, I become as a man without a child, praying over the dead, like the body of the slain that sleep in the grave. Even thou rememberest the Lord, they are cut off from thy hand. That they be in the lowest pit, in darkness, and in the shadow of death. Against me is thy anger made strong, and all thy wills have left brought upon me. Thou hast removed my friends apart from me, they have made me an abomination unto themselves. I have been delivered up, and I have not come forth. My eyes are going weak from poverty. I promise thee, O Lord, to hold thee long, and I stretch out my hands to thee. Nay, to the dead wilt thou plunder, so shall the physicians raise them up, that they may give thanks unto thee. Nay, shall any of the great soul of thy mercy, and thy truth, and thy destruction. Nay, shall thy wonders be known in thy darkness, and thy righteousness in that land that is the mountain. Thus, to me is thee, O Lord, that I cry, and in the morning shall I curse before thee. Wherefore, Lord, dost thou cast off my soul, and turn away thy face from me? A poor man am I, and the children of my youth, yea, having been exalted, I was humbled above the distress. Thy fears have passed apart me, and thy terrors have sort of troubled me. They came round about me like water all day long, they have stood about together. They have passed through this bar for me, friend and neighbor, and my acquaintance is because of my misery. O Lord God of my salvation, by day have I cried, and I am before thee. Let my prayer come before thee, bow down my ears and my supplication. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that he has done before me. Bless the Lord, O my soul, not forget not all that he has done for me. Who is gracious unto all thine iniquities, healeth all thine infirmities. Who redeemeth thy life from corruption, who crowneth thee with mercy and compassion, who fulfilleth thy desire with good things, that you should be renewed as the eagles. The Lord performeth deeds of mercy and executeth his judgment for all that are wrong. He hath made his ways known unto Moses and the sons of Israel, the things that he loved. Compassionate and merciful is the Lord, long suffering and plenteous in mercy. God is at the end of the year, and the Lord's return is evil to draw. Not according to our iniquities hath he dealt with us, neither according to our sins hath he rewarded us. For according to the man coming from the earth, the wind of the day diverges the ground with them appearing. As far as the east is from the west, so far hath he removed our iniquities from us. Like as a father hath compassion upon his son, so if the Lord hath compassion upon them appearing. For he knoweth wherever we are made, and he hath removed that beard us. As for man, his days are as grass, and the flower of the field that shall be brought forth. For when the winds pass over, then it will be gone, and no longer will the field be placed around. For the mercy of the Lord is from eternity. Even as the eternity upon him that fear him, and in righteousness is upon the sons of sons, upon him that keep his testament, and in reverence his commandments to them. The Lord in heaven hath prepared his throne, and his kingdom rules over all. Bless the Lord, all ye saints, mighty in strength, that perform his word to hear the voice of his word. Bless the Lord, all his hosts, and minister to him his will. Bless the Lord, all his works, and every place of his dominion. Bless the Lord, my soul. And every place of his dominion, bless the Lord, my soul. O Lord, hear my prayer, and hear my supplication, and thy truth. Hearken unto me in thy righteousness, and do not judge me with thy servant. For thy sight shall a man be justified. For the enemy hath persecuted my soul, and hath humbled my life unto the earth. He has sat me in darkness, so I drove out in long death. And my spirit within me has become his body. Within me my heart is troubled. I remember days of old, I meditated on all my works. I pondered on the creation of thy hands. I stretched forth my hands unto thee. My soul thirsts for thy living like the one of this land. Quickly hear me, O Lord. My spirit hath fainted away. Turn not thy face away from me, lest I be like them that go down into the pit. Cause me to hear thy mercy in the morning, for in thee have I put my hope. Cause me to know the way when I should walk, lest thee have I listened to my soul. Rescue me from my enemies, O Lord, lest thee have I fled for refuge. That I woke up, my God. My good spirit shall lead me in the land of uprightness, for thy name's sake, O Lord, be ever with me. And thy righteousness shall cover my soul out of affliction, and thy mercy shall not utterly destroy my enemies. And thou shalt cut off all from them with my soul. For I am thy servant. The Lord give ear to my supplication, and if not, his judgment be his servant. The Lord give ear to my supplication, and if not, his judgment be his servant. My good spirit shall lead me in the land of uprightness. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Now the Holy Spirit is made coming. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. For our God and our Lord, glory to thee.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
The peace of the whole world, the good estate of the holy churches of God, and communion of all men, Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house and for those who obey purpose in the fear of God and for their end. For our Father, Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priest of the Diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Metropolitan Paul and Archbishop John, for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the President of the United States and all civil authorities and armed forces everywhere, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city and for every city and land, for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and suffering, for captives and their salvation, for those under persecution for the faith, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Our deliverance from all tribulation, wrapped into necessity, help us, save us, have mercy upon us. Keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in your remembrance, our holy immaculate, most blessed, glorious, keep him from us ever merit. All the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto you, Christ our God.
For
unto the earth you all glory, honor, and worship, the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Thank you.
counted worthy to hear the Holy Gospel, let us pray to the Lord God.
Lord, have mercy.
Dearest of attend, let us hear the Holy Gospel and peace be to all. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
Let us attend. The Lord said to his disciples, now is the Son of Man glorified, and in him God is glorified. If God is glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself, and glorify him at once. Little children, yet a little while I am with you. You will seek me, and as I said to the Jews, so now I say to you, where I am going, you cannot come. A new commandment I give you, that you love one another, even as I have loved you, that you also love one another. By this, all men will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another. Simon Peter said to Jesus, Lord, where are you going? Jesus answered, where I am going you cannot follow me now, but you shall follow afterward. Peter said to him, Lord, why cannot I follow you now? I will lay down my life for your sake. Jesus answered, will you lay down your life for my sake? Truly, truly, I say to you, the cock will not crow till you have denied me three times. Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And when I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again, and I will take you to myself, that where I am, you may be also. And where I am going, you know, and the way you know. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but by me. If you had known me, you would have known my Father also. Henceforth you know him and have seen him. Philip said to him, Lord, show us the Father, and we shall be satisfied. Jesus said to him, have I been so with you so long, and you do not know me, Philip? He who has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, show us the Father? Do you not believe that I am in the Father, and the Father in me? The words that I say to you, I do not speak on my own authority. But the Father who dwells in me does the works. Believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father in me. Or else believe me for the sake of the works themselves. Truly, truly, I say to you, he who believes in me will also do the works that I do, and greater works than these will he do, because I go to my Father. Whatever you ask in my name, I will do it, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you ask anything in my name, I will do it. If you love me, keep my commandments. And I will pray the Father, and he will give you another counselor, to be with you forever, even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. You know him, for he dwells with you, and will be in you. I will not leave you desolate. I will come to you. Yet a little while, and the world will see me no more. But you will see me. Because I live, you will live also. In that day you will know that I am in my Father, you and me, and I and you. He who has my commandments and keeps them, he it is who loves me. And he who loves me will be loved by my Father, and I will love him and manifest myself to him. Judas, not Iscariot, said to him, Lord, how is it that you will manifest yourself to us and not to the world? Jesus answered him, if a man loves me, he will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him and make our home with him. He who does not love me does not keep my words, and the word which you hear is not mine, but the Father's who sent me. These things I have spoken to you while I am still with you. But the Counselor, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you all things, and bring to your remembrance all that I have said to you. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. Not as the world gives do I give to you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. You heard me say to you, I go away, and I will come to you. If you loved me, you would have rejoiced, because I go to the Father, for my Father is greater than I. And now I have told you before it takes place, so that when it does take place, you may believe. I will no longer talk much with you, for the ruler of this world is coming. He has no power over me, but I do as the Father has commanded me, so that the world may know that I love the Father. Rise, let us go hence. I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine dresser. Every branch of mine that bears no fruit, he takes away. And every branch that does bear fruit, he prunes, that it may bear more fruit. You are already made clean by the word which I have spoken to you. Abide in me, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit by itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. He who abides in me and I in him, he it is that bears much fruit. For apart from me, you can do nothing. If a man does not abide in me, he is cast forth as a branch and withers, and the branches are gathered, thrown into the fire and burned. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, ask whatever you will, and it shall be done for you. By this my Father is glorified, that you bear much fruit, and so prove to be my disciples. As the Father has loved me, so I love you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. These things I have spoken to you, that my joy may be in you, that your joy may be full. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. Greater love has no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. You are my friends, if you do what I command you. No longer do I call you servants, for the servant does not know what his master is doing. But I have called you friends, for all that I have heard from my Father I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I chose you, and appointed you, that you should go and bear fruit, that your fruit should abide, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give it to you. This I command you, love one another. If the world hates you, know that it has hated me before it hated you. If you were of the world would love itself. But because you are not of the world, but I chose you out of the world, therefore the world hates you. Remember the word that I said to you, a servant is not greater than his master. If they persecuted me, they will persecute you. If they kept my word, they will keep yours also. But all this they will do to you for my name's sake, because they do not know him who sent me. If I had not come and spoken to them, they would not have sinned. But now they have no excuse for their sin. He who hates me hates my Father also. If I had not done among them the works which no one else did, they would not have sinned. But now they have seen and hated both me and my Father. It is to fulfill the word that is written in their law. They hated me without a cause. But when the Counselor comes, whom I shall send you from the Father, even the Spirit of truth, who proceeds from the Father, he will bear witness to me. And you also are witnesses, because you have been with me from the beginning. I have said all this to you to keep you from falling away. They will put you out of the synagogues. Indeed, the hour is coming when whoever kills you will think he's offering service to God. And they will do this because they have not known the Father nor me. But I have said these things to you, that when their hour comes, you may remember that I told you of them. I did not say these things to you from the beginning, because I was with you. But now I am going to him who sent me. Yet now do you ask me, where are you going? But because I have said these things to you, sorrow has filled your hearts. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth, that it is to your advantage that I go away. For if I do not go away, the Counselor will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you. And when he comes, he will convict the world concerning sin and righteousness and judgment. Concerning sin, because they do not believe in me. Concerning righteousness, because I go to the Father and you will see me no more. Concerning judgment, because the ruler of this world is judged. I have yet many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. When the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into all the truth. For he will not speak on his own authority, but whatever he hears, he will speak, and he will declare to you the things that are to come. He will glorify me, for he will take what is mine and declare it to you. All that the Father has is mine. Therefore I said that he will take what is mine and declare it to you. A little while, and you will see me no more. Again a little while, and you will see me, because I go to the Father. Some of his disciples said to one another, what is this that he says to us, a little while, and you will not see me, and again a little while, and you will see me, and because I go to the Father? They said, what does he mean by a little while? We do not know what he means. Jesus knew that they wanted to ask him, so he said to them, is this what you are asking yourselves, what I meant by saying, a little while, and you will not see me, and again a little while, and you will see me? Truly, truly, I say to you, you will weep and lament, but the world will rejoice. You will be sorrowful, but your sorrow will be turned into joy. When a woman is in travail, she has sorrow because her hour has come. But when she is delivered of the child, she no longer remembers her anguish or joy that a child is born into the world. So you have sorrow now, but I will see you again, and your hearts will rejoice, and no one will take your joy from you. In that day you will ask nothing of me. Truly, truly, I say to you, if you ask anything of the Father, he will give it to you in my name. Hitherto you have not asked nothing in my name. Ask and you will receive, that your joy may be full. I have said this to you in figures. The hour is coming when I shall no longer speak to you in figures, but show you plainly of the Father. In that day you will ask in my name, and I do not say to you that I shall pray the Father for you, for the Father himself loves you, because you have loved me and have believed that I came from God. I came from the Father and have come into the world. Again, I am leaving the world and going to the Father. His disciples said, Abba, now you are speaking plainly, not in any figure. Now we know that you know all things and need none to question you. By this we believe that you came from God. Jesus answered them, Do you now believe? The hour is coming, indeed it has come, when you will be scattered, every man to his own, and will leave me alone. Yet I am not alone, for my Father is with me. I have said this to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. When Jesus had spoken these words, he lifted up his eyes to heaven and said, Father, the hour has come. Glorify thy Son, that thy Son may glorify thee, since thou hast given him power over all flesh, to give eternal life to all whom thou hast given him. And this is eternal life, that they know thee, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom thou hast sent. I glorify thee on earth, having accomplished the work which thou gavest me to do. And now, Father, glorify thou me with thine own self, which the glory which I had with thee before the world was. I have manifested thy name to the men whom thou gavest me out of the world. Thine they were, and thou gavest them to me, and they have kept thy word. Now they know everything that thou hast given me is from thee, for I have given them the words which thou gavest me, and they have received them, and know in truth that I came from thee. And they have believed that thou didst send me. I am praying for them. I am not praying for the world, but for those thou hast given me, for they are thine. All mine are thine, and thine are mine, and I am glorified in them. And now I am no more in the world, but they are in the world, and I am coming to thee. Holy Father, keep them in thy name which thou hast given me, that they may be one, even as we are. When I was with them in the world, I kept them in thy name which thou hast given me. I have guarded them, and none of them is lost, but the son of perdition, that the scripture might be fulfilled. But now I am coming to thee, and these things I speak in the world, that they may have my joy fulfilled in themselves. I have given them thy word, and the world has hated them, because they are not of the world, even as I am not of the world. I do not pray that thou shouldst take them out of the world, but thou shouldst keep them from the evil one. They are not of the world, even as I am not of the world. Sanctify them in thy truth. Thy word is truth. As thou hast sent me into the world, so I have sent them into the world. And for their sake I sanctify myself, that they also may be sanctified in truth. I do not pray for these only, but also for those who believe in me through their word, that they may all be one, even as thou, Father, art in me and I in thee, that they also may be one in us, so that the world may believe that thou hast sent me. The glory which thou hast given me I have given to them, that they may be one even as we are one. I in them, and thou in me, that they may become perfectly one, so that the world may know that thou hast sent me, and hast loved them even as thou hast loved me. Father, I desire that they also whom thou hast given me may be where I am, to behold my glory which thou hast given me. For thou lovest me before the foundation of the world. O righteous Father, the world has not known me, but I have known thee, and these know that thou hast sent me. I made known to them thy name, and I will make it known, that the love with which thou hast loved me may be in them, and I in them. When Jesus had spoken these words, he went forth with his disciples across the Kidron Valley, where there is a garden, which he and his disciples entered.
Glory to thy own suffering, Lord, glory to thee.
Words contrary to the law, they contrived against me. our burden to thwart him without despair and effort, that he may save the tribulations to those who take refuge in thee, for he is the love of God.
We need you, Jesus, O Lord, to the resurrection of Lazarus, he'll be saved, Hosanna, the lover of man, Christ. But love, pray, he knew that he reached on his bed. Thou didst foretell it as thy supper, O Christ God, and said to thy disciples, verily one of you shall betray me, but all bring him to this peace to understand. When John asked thee, O Lord, who shall betray thee, thou didst point him out to him by means of the bread, but the law bring him to this peace to understand. The Jews called thy death with 30 pieces of silver and pieces of deceit, but the law bring him to this peace to understand. At the washing of thy disciples, O Christ God, thou didst urge them, saying, as ye have seen, do so do ye. But the law brings you this peace to understand. Thou dost tell thy disciples, O God, watch and pray, lest ye be tempted. But the law brings you this peace to understand. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Deliver thy servant to tribulation, O Lord, that will be all after God. Seek refuge in thee, since thou art an impregnable fortress and an intercessor.
When thou didst help the disciples, let us suffer, and knewest the intent of Judas to betray, thou didst reproach him for it, knowing all the while that he must be on redemption, but preferring to make them to that thou wast betrayed.
Judas, procuring a band of soldiers and officers from the chief priests and the Pharisees, went there with lanterns and torches and weapons. Then Jesus, knowing all that was to befall him, came forward and said to them, whom do you seek? And they answered him, Jesus of Nazareth. And Jesus said to them, I am he. And Judas, who betrayed him, was standing with them. And when Jesus said to them, I am he, they drew back and fell to the ground. And again Jesus asked them, whom do you seek? And they said, Jesus of Nazareth. And Jesus answered, I told you that I am he. So if you seek me, let these men go. And this was to fulfill the word which was spoken of those whom you gave it me, I lost not one. Then Simon Peter, having a sword, drew it and struck the high priest's servant and cut off his right ear. And the servant's name was Malchus. And Jesus said to Peter, put your sword into its sheath. Shall I not drink the cup which the Father has given me? And so the band of soldiers and their captain and the officers of the Jews seized Jesus and bound him. First they led him to Annas, for he was the father-in-law of Caiaphas, who was high priest that year. And it was Caiaphas who had given counsel to the Jews that it was expedient that one man should die for the people. Simon Peter followed Jesus, and so did another disciple. And as this disciple was known to the high priest, he entered the court of the high priest along with Jesus. And while Jesus stood outside at the door. So the other disciple, who was known to the high priest, went out and spoke to the maid who kept the door and brought Peter in. The maid who kept the door said to Peter, "Are not you also one of this man's disciples?" And Peter said, "I am not." And now the servants and officers had made a charcoal fire because it was cold, and they were warming themselves. And Peter also was with them, standing and warming himself. The high priest then questioned Jesus about his disciples and his teaching, and Jesus answered him, "I have spoken openly to the world. I have always taught in the synagogue and in the temple, where all Jews come together. I have said nothing secretly. Why do you ask me? Ask those who have heard me. What I said to them, they know what I said." And when Jesus had said this, one of the officers standing by struck him with his hand, saying, "Is that how you answer the high priest?" And Jesus answered him, "If I have spoken wrongly, bear witness to the wrong. But if I have spoken rightly, why do you strike me?" And Annas then sent him bound to Caiaphas, the high priest. Now Simon Peter was standing and warming himself, and they said to him, "Are you not also one of his disciples?" And he denied it and said, "I am not." And one of the disciples of the high priest, a kinsman of the man whose ear Peter had cut off, asked, "Did I not see you in the garden with him?" And Peter again denied it, and at once the cock crowed. Then they led Jesus from Caiaphas to the praetorium. It was early, and they themselves did not enter the praetorium, so that they might not be defiled, but might eat the Passover.
Glory to the Lord, suffering Lord, glory to thee.
Today, Judas, the master, followeth after Satan. He is darkened by the wisdom, blinded by the suffering of the love, by the suffering of the love of silver, and fell from the light. For how can he see who sold the star, the 30 pieces of silver? But he who suffered for our sake hath shown forth upon us. Wherefore let us hail him, saying, "O thou who didst suffer and pity for mankind, glory be to thee." To thee Judas adulterated the worship of God and become strange from the guest. He was a disciple and became a betrayer. He covered deceit with the semblance of friendship and preferred 30 pieces of silver to the love of the master, becoming the guide to the council of law transgressors. But having Christ as our salvation, let us glorify him. O brethren, let us take possession of brotherly love as brethren of Christ, not mercilessness towards our neighbor, lest we be condemned as a merciless servant for the sake of money, nor repent like Judas when such repentance avails us not. Glory to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, both now and in the age of ages. Amen. Glorious things have been spoken to thee everywhere, O Mary Theotokos, who didst give birth in the flesh without wedlock to the Creator of all, all praise.
The disciple bargained over the price of the master, selling the Lord for 30 pieces of silver. And with a deceitful kiss, he delivered him to those who are without law to kill him. The day the Creator of heaven and earth said to his disciples, "The hour draweth near, and Judas, my betrayer, approacheth. Wherefore, let no one deny thee when he seeth thee on the cross between two thieves. For as man I shall suffer and save those who believe in thee, for I am the lover of mankind. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, as with his ages. Amen. O thou who in the last day didst conceived ineffably, and didst give birth to thy Creator, save, O Virgin, those who magnify thee.
Today Jesus watches the night to deliver thee, eternal Lord, the Savior of the world, to satisfy the multitude with five loaves. Today that lawless one denied his master, disciple he was, yet delivered to the master, selling fruits over him who fed man with manna. Today the Jews nailed on the cross him who did cleave the sea with a rod, and made him to pass through the wilderness. Today they appear to the spear the side of him who scourged Egypt with curses for their sake, and who will give him bitterness to drink to rain down manna for their nourishment. When thou came to thy suffering willingly, O Lord, thou hast cried out to the disciples, "If ye cannot walk with me 1 hour, would die for me. Rather see ye how Judas sleepeth not, but hasten to deliver me to those who disobey the law. Arise and pray, and let no one deny me when he sees me on the cross. Wherefore, O long-suffering one, glory be to thee. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and in gracious and ages. Amen. Rejoice, O Theotokos, who didst hold in thy womb him whom the heavens hold not. Rejoice, O Virgin, whom the prophets preached, from whom Emmanuel shone forth upon us. Rejoice, O Mother of Christ God.
What was it God drew us to betray our Savior? Did he serve his Lord from the disciples? Did he deny the gift of healing? Did he
they might put him to death, but they found none, though many false witnesses came forward. At last two came forward and said, "This fellow said, I am able to destroy the temple of God and to build it in 3 days." And the high priest stood up and said, "Have ye no answer to make? What is it that these men testify against you?" But Jesus was silent. And the high priest said to him, "I adjure you by the living God, tell us if you are the Christ, the Son of God." Jesus said to him, "You have said so, but I tell you hereafter, you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of the power and coming on clouds of heaven." Then the high priest tore his robes and said, "He has uttered blasphemy. Why do we still need witnesses? You have now heard his blasphemy. What is your judgment?" They answered, "He deserves death." Then they spat in his face and struck him and slapped him, saying, "Prophesy to us, you Christ. Who is it that struck you?" Now Peter was sitting outside in the courtyard, and a maid came up to him and said, "You also were with Jesus the Galilean." But he denied it before them all, saying, "I do not know what you mean." And when he went out to the porch, another maid saw him, and she said to the bystanders, "This man was with Jesus of Nazareth." And again Peter denied it with, "No, I do not know the man." After a little while, the bystanders came up and said to Peter, "Certainly you are also one of them, for your accent betrays you." Then Peter began to invoke a curse on himself and to swear, "I do not know the man," and immediately the cock crowed. And Peter remembered the saying of Jesus, "Before the cock crows, you will deny me 3 times. And Peter went out and wept bitterly.
Glory to
thy long suffering,
Lord, glory to thee.
Do patience and forbearance, let us cry out, O Lord, to be law violators, to lay hold of thee, saying, "If you have stricken this shepherd and dispersed my disciples, these 12 sheep, I am able to bring more than 12 ranks of angels. And suffer ye long that they may be fulfilled, which I have revealed to you through my prophets of mysteries and hidden things. Wherefore, O Lord, hear your repentance, saying, God, forgive me and save me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and in the ages of ages. Amen. Let us pray to the Holy Virgin, for she is the Lord's salvation and the life of paradise, and a cloud unto the eternal life. And let us all hail her, saying, rejoice.
Say ye, O transgressors of the law, what heard you from our Savior? Is it not that he appointed the law and the teachings of the prophets? How then did you think to deliver Pilate the Lord, God of God, and the deliverer of our souls? They who benefited always by thy gifts, O Christ, were crying, let them be crucified, and the killers of the righteous sought to free an evildoer in place of the benefactor. But thou was silent, enduring their arrogance, wishing to suffer and to save us, since thou art the lover of mankind. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and for great days. Amen. For verily we have no favor for the multitude of our sins. Therefore, Virgin Theotokos, plead with him who was born in thee, for the pleadings of the mother are greatly effective in winning the favor of the Master. Turn thou not away, therefore, from the pleadings of sinners, O most venerable. For he who is willing to suffer for our sins is merciful and able to save us.
Verily said the 30 pieces of silver, the price of him that we value, whom they of the children of Israel did value. Watch ye and pray, lest ye enter into temptation, for the spirit is ready, but the flesh is weak. Wherefore, watch ye. They gave me gall in my meat, and in my thirst they gave me vinegar to drink. But thou, Lord, raise me that I may reward them. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and in the ages of ages. Amen. We who are of the Gentiles, pray thee, O undefiled Theotokos, for thou didst bear Christ our God, who through thee delivered mankind from the curse.
So Pilate went out to them and said, what accusation do you bring against this man? They answered him, if this man were not an evildoer, we would not have handed him over. Pilate said to them, take him yourselves and judge him by your own law. The Jews said to him, it is not lawful for us to put any man to death. This was to fulfill the word which Jesus had spoken to show by what death he was to die. Pilate entered the praetorium again and called Jesus and said to him, are you the king of the Jews? Jesus answered, do you say this of your own accord, or did others say it to you about me? Pilate answered, am I a Jew? Your own nation and the chief priests have handed you over to me. What have you done? Jesus answered, my kingdom is not of this world. If my kingdom were of this world, my servants would fight, that I might not be handed over to the Jews. But my kingdom is not from this world. Pilate said to him, so you are a king? Jesus answered, "You say that I am a king. For this I was born, and for this I have come into the world, to bear witness to the truth. Everyone who is of the truth hears my voice." Pilate said to him, "What is truth?" After Pilate had said this, he went out to the Jews again and told them, I find no crime in him. But you have a custom that I should release one man for you at the Passover. Will you have me release for you the king of the Jews?" They cried out again, "Not this man, but Barabbas." Now Barabbas was a robber. Then Pilate took Jesus and scourged him, and the soldiers plaited a crown of thorns and put it on his head and arrayed him in a purple robe. And they came up to him saying, "Hail, King of the Jews," and struck him with their hands. Pilate went out again and said to them, "See, I am bringing him out to you, that you may know that I find no crime in him." So Jesus came out, wearing the crown of thorns and the purple robe. Pilate said to them, "Behold the man." When the chief priests and the officers saw him, they cried out, "Crucify him! Crucify him!" Pilate said to them, "Take him yourselves and crucify him, for I find no crime in him." The Jews answered him, "We have a law, and by our law he ought to die, because he has made himself the Son of God." When Pilate heard these words, he was the more afraid. He entered the praetorium again and said to Jesus, "Where are you from?" But Jesus gave no answer. Pilate therefore said to him, "You will not speak to me? Do you not know that I have power to crucify you and power to release you?" Jesus answered him, "You would have no power over me unless it had been given you from above. Therefore he who delivered me to you has the greater sin." Upon this, Pilate sought to release him, but the Jews cried out, "If you release this man, you are not Caesar's friend. Everyone who makes himself a king speaks against Caesar." When Pilate heard these words, he brought Jesus out and sat down on the judgment seat at a place called the Pavement, and in Hebrew, Golgotha. Now it was the day of preparation of the Passover. It was about the sixth hour. Pilate said to the Jews, "Behold your king." They cried out, "Away with him! Away with him! Crucify him!" Pilate said to them, "Shall I crucify your king?" The chief priests answered, "We have no king but Caesar." Then he handed Jesus over to them to be crucified.
Thank you.
counted worthy to hear the holy gospel, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom attend, let us hear the holy gospel.
Peace be to all.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
Let us attend. At that time, when Judas, his betrayer, saw that Jesus was condemned, he felt regret and brought back the 30 pieces of silver to the chief priests and the elders, saying, I have sinned in betraying innocent blood. They said, what is that to us? See to it yourself. And throwing down the pieces of silver to the temple, he departed, and he went and hanged himself. But the chief priests, taking the pieces of silver, said, it is not lawful to put them into the treasury, since they are blood money. So they took counsel and bought with them the potter's field to bury strangers in. Therefore that field has been called the field of blood this day. Then was fulfilled what had been spoken by the prophet Jeremiah, saying, and they took the 30 pieces of silver, the price of him who was valued by the sons of Israel, and they gave them for the potter's field, as the Lord directed me. Now Jesus stood before the governor, and the governor asked him, are you the king of the Jews? Jesus said, you have said so. But when he was accused by the chief priests and elders, he made no answer. Then Pilate said to him, do you not hear how many things they testified against you? But Jesus gave him no answer, not even to a single charge, so that the governor wondered greatly. Now at the feast, the governor was accustomed to release before the crowd any one prisoner whom they wanted, and they had then a notorious prisoner called Barabbas. So when they had gathered, Pilate said to them, whom do you want me to release to you, Barabbas or Jesus who is called Christ? For he knew that it was out of envy that they had delivered him up. Besides, while he was sitting on the judgment seat, his wife sent word to him, have nothing to do with that righteous man, for I have suffered much over him today in a dream. Now the chief priests and the elders persuaded the people to ask for Barabbas and destroy Jesus. The governor again said to them, which of the two do you want me to release for you? And they said, Barabbas. Pilate said to them, then what shall I do with Jesus, who is called Christ? They all said, let him be crucified. And Pilate said, why? What evil has he done? But they shouted all the more, let him be crucified. So when Pilate saw that he was gaining nothing, but rather that a riot was beginning, he took water and washed his hands before the crowd, saying, I am innocent of this righteous man's blood. See to it yourselves. And all the people answered, his blood be on us and on our children. Then Pilate released for them Barabbas, and having scourged Jesus, delivered him to be crucified. Then the soldiers of the governor took Jesus into the praetorium, and they gathered the whole battalion before him, and they stripped him and put a scarlet robe upon him, and plaiting a crown of thorns, they put it on his head, and put a reed in his right hand. And kneeling before him, they mocked him, saying, hail, King of the Jews! And they spat upon him, and took the reed, and struck him on the head. And when they had mocked him, they stripped him of the robe, and put his own clothes on him, and led him away to crucify him. As they went out, they came upon a man of Cyrene, Simon by name. This man they compelled to carry the cross of Jesus.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
led Jesus away inside the palace, that is the Praetorium. And they called together the whole battalion. And they clothed him in a purple cloak, and plaiting a crown of thorns, they put it on him. And they began to salute him, "Hail, King of the Jews." And they struck his head with a reed, and spat upon him. And they knelt down in homage to him. And when they had mocked him, they stripped him of the purple cloak, and put his own clothes on him. And they led him out to crucify him. And they compelled a passerby, Simon of Cyrene, who was coming in from the country, the father of Alexander and Rufus, to carry the cross of Jesus. And they brought Jesus to the place called Golgotha, which means the place of the skull. And they offered him wine mingled with myrrh, but he did not take it. And they crucified him, and divided his garments among them, casting lots for them, to decide what each should take. And it was the third hour when they crucified him, and the inscription of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews." And with him they crucified two robbers, one on his right and one on his left. And the scripture was fulfilled, which says, "He was reckoned with the transgressors." And those who passed by derided him, wagging their heads, saying, "Aha, you who would destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself and come down from the cross." So also the chief priests mocked him to one another with the scribes, saying, "He saved others, he cannot save himself." Let the Christ, the King of Israel, come down now from the cross, that we may see and believe.
Glory to my long-suffering Lord, glory to thee.
Thank you.
deliver among the dead, finding there the usurper, and delivering all the bonds of death by thy resurrection, by which we have been enlightened. Wherefore we cry to thee, O lover of mankind, to remember us in thy kingdom.
Rejoice and be exceeding glad, for great is your reward in heaven.
O Lord, who was elevated on the cross, who being God, loosed the bonds of death, and blotted out the handwriting of ordinances against us, grant us and the thief his repentance. O thou who art alone loved of mankind, us who worship thee in faith, O Christ our God, in Christ thee, remember him and us in thy kingdom.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Holy believers, let us with one mind beseech, glorifying as the King of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, the one God has in three persons, permanent without confusion, simple, indivisible, and unapproachable, through whom we escape the ire of punishment.
Oh, now and ever, and to ages of ages, amen.
We offer thee for intercession, O most merciful Christ, Lord, thy mother, holy virgin, who without seed gave thee birth to the body and remained without corruption after her birth to thee, that thou mightest forgive the transgressions of those who try to be constantly. Remember him and us, O Savior, in thy kingdom.
Depart, my garments from all them, and depart my vestures, they have holes. Depart, my garments from all them, and depart my vestures, they have holes. My God, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? Depart, my garments from all them, and upon my vesture they cast lots.
Departed
my garments among them, and upon my vesture they cast lots.
And that we may be accounted worthy to hear the Holy Gospel, let us pray to the Lord God.
Mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Hear, sinner, let us hear the Holy Gospel. Peace be to all.
Reading
from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
Let us attend. At that time, soldiers led Jesus to a place called Golgotha, which means the place of a skull, and they offered him wine to drink mingled with gall. But when he tasted it, he would not drink it. And when they had crucified him, they divided his garments among them by casting lots, that what was spoken by the prophet might be fulfilled. They parted my garments among them, and for my clothing they cast lots. Then they sat down and kept watch over him there. And over his head they put the charge against him, which read, "This is Jesus, the King of the Jews." Then two robbers were crucified with him, one on the right and one on the left. And those who passed by derided him, wagging their heads and saying, "You who would destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself. If you are the Son of God, come down from the cross." So also the chief priests and with the scribes and the elders mocked him, saying, "He saved others, he cannot save himself. If he is the King of Israel, let him come down now from the cross, and we will believe in him. He trusts in God. Let God deliver him now if he desires him. For he said, 'I am the Son of God.'" And the robbers who were crucified with him also reviled him in the same way. Now from the sixth hour there was darkness all over the land until the ninth hour. And at about the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, "Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani," that is, my God, why hast thou forsaken me?" And some of the bystanders, hearing it, said, "This man is calling for Elijah." And one of them at once ran and took a sponge, filled it with vinegar, and put it on a reed and gave it to him to drink. But the other said, "Wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to save him." And Jesus cried again with a loud voice and gave up the spirit. And behold, the temple, the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom, and the earth shook and the rocks were split. The tombs also were opened, and many bodies of the saints who had fallen asleep were raised. And coming out of the tombs after his resurrection, They went into the holy city and appeared to many. When the centurion and those who were with them, keeping watch over Jesus, saw the earthquake and what took place, they were filled with awe and said, "Truly this man was the Son of God."
Glory to the Lord, glory to
Friday, we celebrate the holy dread and saving passion of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ. The spittings, blows, and scourges, the curses, cheers, and the wearing of the purple, the rod, sponge, and vinegar, the nails, the spear, and especially the cross of death, which we receive willingly for our sakes. We celebrate also the confession of salvation, which the grateful thief made on the cross with him.
And
have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Call into your remembrance all the holy, immaculate, most blessed, and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
After this, Jesus, knowing that all was now finished, said, to fulfill the scripture, I thirst. A bowl full of vinegar stood there, so they put a sponge full of vinegar on hyssop and held it to his mouth. When Jesus had received the vinegar, he said, it is finished, and he bowed his head and gave up the spirit. Since it was the day of preparation, in order to prevent the bodies from remaining on the cross on the Sabbath, that Sabbath was a high day. The Jews asked Pilate that their legs might be broken and that they might be taken away. So the soldiers came and broke the legs of the first and of the other who had been crucified with them. But when they came to Jesus and saw that he was already dead, they did not break his legs. But one of the soldiers pierced his side with a spear, and at once there came up blood and water. He who saw it is borne witness. This testimony is true, and he knows that he tells the truth, that you may also believe. For these things took place that the scripture might be fulfilled. Not a bone of him shall be broken. And again the scripture says, they shall look on him whom they have pierced.
Glory to thy long-suffering Lord, glory to thee.
Thank you.
count it worthy to hear the holy gospel, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom attend, let us hear the holy gospel.
Peace be to all.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Mark.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
Let us attend. At that time, Joseph of Arimathea, a respected member of the council, who was also himself looking for the kingdom of God, took courage and went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. And Pilate wondered if he were already dead. And summoning the centurion, he asked him whether Jesus was already dead. And when he learned from the centurion that Jesus was dead, he granted the body to Joseph. And he bought a linen shroud, and taking Jesus down, wrapped him in the linen shroud, and laid him in a tomb which had been hewn out of the rock. And he rolled a stone against the door of the tomb. Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of Jose, saw where Jesus was laid.
Glory to thy own suffering, Lord, glory to thee.
Thine is the glory, O Lord, our God, and to thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, to which the days of the
glory be to God on high and on earth, peace and will upon men.
We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee, to thy great glory.
O Lord, heavenly King, God, the Father, Almighty, the Lord, the living God, the Son, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit. O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us.
For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, O Jesus Christ. Glory to God the Father. Amen.
Every day when I bless thee, I will praise thy name forever, yea, forever and ever.
Lord, thou hast been our refuge in all generations. I said, Lord, be merciful unto me, heal my soul, for I have sinned against thee.
Lord, I fled unto thee, teach me to do thy will, for thou art my God, for he is the fountain of life. In thy light shall we see life. O continue thy loving kindness unto them that know thee.
Thou save, O Lord, and keep us this day without sin.
Blessed art thou, Lord, God of our fathers, and praised and glorified thy name forever. Amen.
Let thy mercy be upon us, O Lord, even as we have set our hope in thee.
Blessed art thou, O Lord, teach me thy statutes.
Blessed art thou, O Master, make me to understand thy commandments.
Blessed art thou, O Lord, enlighten me with thy precepts.
Thy mercy, O Lord, endureth forever, and despise not the host of thy hand.
To thee belongeth worship, to thee belongeth praise. To thee belongeth glory, to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Now and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
Let us complete our morning prayer unto the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
And the whole evening may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless. Let us ask of the Lord.
Lord,
angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies. Let us ask of the
Lord.
Pardon and remission of our sins and transgressions. Let us ask of the
Lord.
All things good and profitable for our souls and peace for the world. Let us ask of the
Lord.
That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance. Let us ask of the Lord. Christian ending to our life, blameless, blameless, peaceful, and a good defense before the dread judgment seat of Christ. Let us ask of the Lord. Calling to remembrance our all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
For thou art the God of mercies and bounties and of toward mankind, and to thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
thee, O Holy of Holies, stretch forth thine invisible hand from thy holy dwelling place and bless us all. And if in aught we have sinned, whether voluntarily or involuntarily, forgive inasmuch as thou art a good God and lovest mankind. Vouchsafe unto us thy mercy, thy earthly and heavenly good things. For thine it is to show mercy to save sinners, O our God, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
And that we may be accounted worthy to hear the Holy Gospel, let us pray to the Lord God.
Have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Attend, let us hear the Holy Gospel.
Peace be to all.
And to thy spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
Let us attend. At that time, Joseph of Arimathea, who was a disciple of Jesus but secretly for fear of the Jews, asked Pilate that he might take away the body of Jesus, and Pilate gave him leave. So he came and took away Jesus' body. Nicodemus also, who had at first come to Jesus by night, came bringing a mixture of myrrh and aloes, about 100 pounds weight. They took the body of Jesus and bound it in linen clothes with the spices, as it is the burial custom of the Jews. Now in the place where he was crucified, there was a garden, and in the garden a new tomb where no one had ever been laid. So because of the Jewish day of preparation, as the tomb was close at hand, they laid Jesus there.
Glory to thy long-suffering Lord, glory to thee.
She swallows her breast, crying.
next day, that is, the day of preparation, the chief priests and the Pharisees gathered before Pilate and said, Sir, we remember how that impostor said while he was still alive, After 3 days I will rise again. Therefore, order the sepulchre to be made secure until the third day, lest his disciples go and steal him away and tell the people he has risen from the dead, and the last fraud will be worse than the first. Pilate said to them, You have a guard of soldiers. Go, make it as secure as you can. So they went and made the sepulchre secure by sealing the stone and setting a guard.
Glory to the long suffering Lord, glory to thee.
It is a good thing to confess to the Lord and to sing to thy name Most High, to show forth thy mercy in the morning and thy truth by night. Holy God, holy mighty, holy Lord, have mercy on us.
Holy God, holy mighty, holy Lord, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy Lord, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, cleanse us from our sins. O Master, pardon our iniquities. O Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages.
Amen.
forever. Oh, glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, of now and ever, and of generation to generation. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Father, bless.
May he who endured spittings and scourgings, the cross and death, for the salvation of the world, Christ our true God, through the intercessions of his all-immaculate and all-blessed, blameless Holy Mother, by the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner, and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, and all-laudable apostles, of the holy, glorious, and right victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, of Saint Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Adam, and of all the saints, have mercy upon us and save us, for as much as he is good and loveth mankind. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.